Hello students, welcome to online maths classroom. Today we are going to take up integrals of some particular functions and we will discuss solutions of your NCERT exercise 7.4 based on this property. So let us start with it. We need to use these six formulae, important formulae, to integrate some standard integrals, right? Now, what are they? Like, the formula number one says integral 1 upon x square minus a square dx. Okay, integral 1 upon x square minus a square dx, it will be equal to 1 upon 2a. You know what is a here? Okay, one will be the term involving your variables and other one is a constant, okay, or real number. So 1 upon 2 times a into log mod x minus c upon x plus a plus c. Okay, and the formula for integral 1 upon a square minus x square will be 1 upon 2a log mod a plus x upon a minus x plus c. Now here, see, these two formulas are interconnected, like means how will you remember that which formula will be, means it will be log x minus a upon x plus a. See, in the formula of x square minus a square, at the top it is x minus a, and then at the bottom is it x plus a. And for a square minus x square, a plus x is at the top and a minus x is at the bottom. Number three is integral 1 upon x square plus a square. See, all these are just these formulas are involving negative sign. This one is with positive sign, x square plus a square. So the formula will be 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a plus c. Right? Now let us start with all these three formula in the form of root. Okay? Means if it instead like 1 upon x square minus a square, it is like 1 upon x square minus a square root. So the formula will be log mod x plus x is this function, and plus root this complete term x square minus a square plus c. Right? And for this, say this one, if it is inside root, 1 upon root a square minus x square, the formula is sine inverse x upon a plus c. And integral 1 upon root x square plus a square, this third one with root, if it is there, then it is like your number four formula, that is log mod x plus root x square plus a square plus c. So let us learn it separately. Like we have the formula 1 upon x square minus a square. So how can I integrate? I will integrate it like 1 upon x minus a. I'll factorize it. Okay. And then I can, means I have to involve the terms like this in the numerator. So I'll write this term as 1 upon 2a, right? Means I'll divide and multiply by your 2a, like 1 upon 2a. So it will be a plus a like this. And add and subtract x so that this numerator 1 can be expressed as this. Okay. Now why we have done it? This is the proof of this formula. So that I can just break the numerator and write it as 1 upon x minus a minus 1 upon x plus a. Now this integral has split it in this form, and you know 1 upon linear is always log mod, the integral of it is. So it is log mod x minus a minus log mod x plus a. So it becomes log a minus log b, it is half 1 by 2a log mod x minus a upon x plus a plus c. Similarly for the formula 1 upon a square minus x square, again we'll multiply divide by 2a, okay, like it is a plus x, and write the numerator as like this so that we can, means after breaking we can get reduced term. So it can be written as a plus x plus a minus x so that it breaks like this. And again the log mod integral when adjusted will give you this value. Okay. Number three is your a proof of 1 upon x square plus a square. For this, you, if you remember your trigonometric functions also, we substituted like this. So I'll put x as a tan theta so that dx is a secant square theta d theta. And I'll change it in this. So this is actually the proof also, and it's a question also. So it is a secant square theta d theta upon a square tan square theta plus a square. So it changes to 1 upon a d theta or 1 d theta. So it becomes 1 upon a theta plus c. So when you will from here, tan theta is x upon a. So theta is tan inverse x upon a. So when it, the value is replaced, so we'll get 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a. Right? For this fourth one, I'll put x as a secant theta. Right, dx is a secant theta tan theta, and see how this integral can be changed. This becomes the integral of secant theta d theta, substitution we are using, and it becomes log secant theta plus tan theta plus c1. Okay, now because I have to change the resultant form of a x and a, so I just replace the values of secant. Okay, so secant is your x upon a, and tan can be represented as secant square theta minus 1. See here, secant square theta minus 1. Okay, and root. So take the LCM and adjust, and you'll get the desired value. Okay, so this is how we integrate. For this other case, put x as a sine theta, dx as a cos theta, right? So that this integral reduces to d theta, and we get theta plus c, and it is sine inverse x upon a plus c. And for the last one also, again we'll put x as a tan theta, it is a secant square theta d theta, and as like the case we discussed for formula number 4, this can be integrated to get log mod secant theta plus tan theta plus c1. Okay, so this way, and further after, again we will put your theta as tan inverse x upon a, okay, and we can get the value of tan, and secant can be changed to 10 also, and we will get that integral in the form of log mod x plus root x square plus e square, as we did in number 4. Okay, now here are some types. Now please remember, these are the types, very very important types. Like the first one is your integrals of the form 1 upon ax square plus bx plus c, that is your 1 upon quadratic. Now what do we do actually, that there is a particular form of doing it. We need to change this quadratic in the denominator as a perfect square. So you remember how to change it in as perfect square, as we when we derive the formula of quadratic formula in quadratic equations. So how to reduce a quadratic polynomial to a perfect square form. So firstly, take this make this x square free from a. So take this a outside, so that it changes to x square plus b upon a x plus c upon a. Then add half of b upon a is your b upon 2a. Square of that and subtract that also from this complete expression. The plus term will be added with this, so that it becomes x plus b upon 2a whole square. And c upon a minus this other one, that b square minus 4a square, adjusted with this. Okay, so this quadratic polynomial can be changed to one of the form, means it will be like your formula depending upon the sign of this term. You will get it as it is reduced to your 1 upon a square plus x square plus e square, or x square minus e square, right? Okay, number 8 is your 1 upon under root quadratic. Again, you have to you have to change per make perfect square of this quadratic polynomial, again as we did in number 7, so that we can apply one of the formula. And then is the very important one, linear upon quadratic. Okay, linear upon quadratic. Like at the top there is linear polynomial, and at the bottom it is your quadratic polynomial. So here to break this your numerator, what we do, we put this linear as a times d dx of the denominator, or the quadratic polynomial plus b, right? Then we take the denominator, means it becomes 2 a times 2 ax plus b plus b, right? Then we separate the terms of x, the constant term, and if x square is involved, we separate them also, right? And after equating both sides, we will find the values of a and b, and then we will get the splitting of this polynomial, that how should I split it so that I can integrate it. And remember one thing, that this form when splitted changes to the form of your f dash integral of your f dash x upon fx, okay, fx plus 1 upon quadratic, okay, dx is applied here. So 1 upon quadratic it will change, and f dash x upon fx, you know, it is your you know that f dash x upon fx is your log mod. Okay, so 1 upon quadratic can be integrated like as we did in number 7. Okay, and number 10 is your linear upon under root quadratic. Now linear upon under root quadratic, again the same thing as we did, linear is equal to a times d dx of this quadratic ax without the root, ax square plus bx plus c plus b. Again we'll find a and b, and now this integral will break to the form of, one will be your, no doubt, one will be your 1 upon under root quadratic. Okay, remember, one will be your under root quadratic, for which you have to apply the formula again, you have to reduce it to perfect square, and the other will be the form f x raised to power n, right, into your f dash x, that derivative. Okay, so you know the formula for it is your fx raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So let us start with it, your See, quickly we will see and then we'll take the question of the exercise. Your 1 upon x square minus 16, right? It can be written as x square minus 4 square. Now the formula which is applicable is your 1 upon x square minus a square, which was your 1 upon 2a. A is here 4. It is 1 upon 8 log mod x minus a. See here, x minus a upon x plus a plus c, right? The other one is your dx upon 2x minus x square. Now it is again a quadratic equation, so you have to change it to the form of means you have to make it a perfect square. So again that half of square of coefficient of x needed to be added, and it changes to 1 upon 1 minus x minus 1 whole square. Now put this x minus 1 as t, dx as dt, so that it simply changes to the form of dt upon root 1 minus t square. So it changes to, this is the formula of root a square minus x square, so it is sine inverse t plus c. Okay, and the t is your x minus. So let us start with this exercise 7.4, and we will do these questions. And firstly, just let's understand why what we did, like direct substitution, your substitution is not applicable, or trigonometric substitution is not applicable in these questions, and why we need to do these questions using this formula also. Okay, so see from here, if generally when we substitute, we look for the derivatives, like means if I need to put this x raised to power 6 as t or the complete term as t, I need the derivative as 6x raised to power 5, which is not there, right? And it is not suggested to multiply or divide with the variables. Means constants can be adjusted because variables need to be readjusted. So see, instead of putting this x raised to power 6 as t, I know if I put x cube as t, right, the derivative 3x square dx equal to dt is present in the numerator. See from here, like, okay, so it changes to your dt upon t square plus 1, and now it changes to this form, 1 upon x square plus e square, that is the formula is 1 upon e tan inverse x upon e. So a is here 1, so it becomes to tan inverse t, or tan inverse t value replaced is x cube plus c. Okay, second one is integral 1 upon root 1 plus 4x square. Again I told you, you take this 4 out, okay, so that you just means either you can write it as means perfect square like this also, you can go if you are okay with it, because here the a single term is there, so you can go for this also, means in this way also, or you can take out this 2 outside that way also. So in this form we can directly even apply the formula, and this question be just remember that when we are applying this formula of log mod, like it is x is 2x and this complete term x square plus e square will be like this, you have to divide by this 2x ddx of your 2x, that is 2, okay, so that the formula changes to half of log 2x plus root x square, 4x square plus 1, okay. Or you can, what you can do is take 4 outside, so it will be 1 by 2 and it will be half whole square plus x square. In that way also you can apply the formula. Number 3 is, again this is 1 upon root, your some term is there, x square plus e square, okay. So again it is suggested that it is not the direct term, so you can even go like this also, means you can apply the formula, it is, you can see it is clearly the form 1 upon x square plus e square, okay, and it becomes log mod x plus x square plus e square root, right? So if you have to apply the formula directly, so you will write like log d2 minus x plus, as we did in the previous question, like, and you have to divide by the derivative of 2 minus x, that is minus 1, okay, remember that. If you can go like that, that is okay, but if you don't want to go like that, so what you can do is you put 2 minus x as t, so minus dx equal to dt, or it becomes dt as minus dt upon under root 1 upon t square plus e square, right? And we can apply this formula, okay, and now it becomes minus log of this complete term. So if you want to, don't want to leave the answer in negative, so what you can do is write it as log 1 upon, okay, as you know that we did it in the formula proving of tan x also, so we can do as log 1 is your 0, and log 1 minus log of this complete term, so log 1 is 0, so means it becomes as, means minus 1 can be written as 1 upon this. So this formula is used here to express it in positive form. Number 4 is integral 1 upon 9 minus 25x square. So it is again best suggested that if you can remember like this, that is okay. Otherwise, take that 25 outside as we did. So that way also it is okay, right? So you can go like this also, means 3 square minus 5x square. and apply the formula of it is in this form. So it is sine inverse x upon a. So x here is 5x and a is here 3. But don't forget to divide by the, if you are doing this method, then don't forget to divide by your derivative of 5x, that is 5. So it becomes 1 by 5 sine inverse 5x upon 3 plus c. Number next is your 3x upon 1 plus 2x raised to power 4. Now again you can see it's a power which is big one and the formulas are for just squares. Okay. So see from here I'll put x square as t. 2x dx is dt and the question changes to 3 by 2 times and it is 1 plus 2t square. So again the thing, either you take 2 outside from here, it will be 1 by 2 whole square plus t square. That way all you can write it as root 2t whole square plus 1. And the formula which can directly be applied, it is the form of 1 upon x square plus a square. You know it is 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a plus c. So it is say 3 by 2, 1 upon a. A is here 1, right? And tan inverse x means root 2t upon a is 1 plus c. But remember, if you are doing this by this method, don't forget to divide by the derivative of your root 2t, that is root 2. Okay? So that this is the answer. So both way you can go and resubstitute. Don't forget to resubstitute the value of t, that is x square, right? So either you can take out the constant, means constant from here, this constant term outside means at the earliest, or you can involve it in squares. But if you are involving it in squares, please don't forget to divide by the derivative. So again, this question is there. Here I'll put x cube as t. The question changes to here 1 upon 3 dt upon 1 minus t square. So it is the form of integral 1 upon e square minus x square, which is 1 upon 2 e log mod a plus x upon a minus x. Please write the formulas again and again so that you do not commit any mistake when you have to do the question. Okay, so if you write the formula again and again, it will be easier for you to understand, right? So it becomes your 1 upon 6 log mod, this is 1 plus t upon 1 minus t. Okay, look for the formula of e square minus x square, it is a plus x at the top and a minus x at the bottom. So t is x cube, so 1 plus x cube upon 1 minus x plus c. Number 7 is your this. Now look at this formula. Now by looking at this formula, you can find that whatever we have done, it is not like f dash x upon fx. It is not like anything. So first thing you can view is to break the numerator, separate the terms, right? Now it changes to two integrals, right? Two integrals. One is your x upon root x square minus 1 and it is 1 upon root x square minus 1 square. So it is, you can directly apply the formula to this, like by using this formula, you can write it as minus log mod x plus root x square minus 1. Okay. And for this part, you see, if I put x square minus c from here, we are doing it separately. Means here it is divided by 2 and multiplied by 2. Even if you don't want to do that, you will automatically get put x square minus 1 as t. You'll get 2x dx as dt. So 2x dx will be equal to dt. So you can go by that also, that x dx equal to dt by 2. So it will be your c from here. It is half of 2 is there. So it is 2 into half, that is your root t. And root 2, you know how to integrate it, is integral t minus half, which is your t half upon half. So it is 2 root t. And this is after replacing the value of t, it is like this. Okay. So put both the values of this integral here in this equation 1. So we'll get it as 1 upon 2 times 2 root x square minus 1 plus c minus log mod this. So this 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Okay. And the c by 2 ultimately can be changed to a constant c. Okay. So it is your root x square minus 1 minus log x plus x square minus 1 plus c. Okay. Now like question number 8 is x square upon root x raised to power 6 plus c raised to power 6. So here we'll put x cube as t. So that 3x square dx is dt. And like we can just make it as the derivative required here by multiplying and dividing by 3. But even if it is not done, you know directly from here x square dx will be dt by 3. And the question directly, even not doing this, means there is no need to follow this step. Because as soon as you will put x cube as t, you will get x square dx as dt by 3. So the question changes to 1 by 3 times integral dt upon t square root t square plus a raised to power 6. A raised to power 6 is your a cube whole square. Now it is of this form. So formula will be log mod t plus root t square plus a raised to power 6. Okay. Or cube whole square. Right. And then I can replace the value of t as x cube and get the answer. In number 9, I'll put tan x as t. So that secant square x is dt. X dx is dt. So this changes to dt upon root t square plus 4, or 4 can be written as 2 square. And using this formula, we can get the integral as log mod after putting the value of t as tan x, log mod tan x plus root tan square x plus 4 mod plus c. Okay. Now next comes the types 1 upon quadratic, 1 upon root quadratic, 1 and root quadratic. Okay. Now in all these forms, we need to make the perfect square of the quadratic. Perfect square we have done in our class 10th, where we derived the formula for our quadratic formula. Okay. And in that, what we did, that we will firstly make the coefficient of x square as 1, means whatever is there, we have to divide the whole equation by that coefficient, and then add and subtract the half of coefficient of x whole square. Okay, so let us see how to apply it in questions. Okay, so number 10 is your 1 upon integral root x square plus 2x plus 2. So it is of the form of 1 upon root quadratic. Okay, so as the coefficient of x square is just 1, so I didn't need to make it as 1. So what I'll do is I'll make the coefficient of x is 2x, so half of it is your 1, right? So I'll add and subtract your 1 square. Now see, when I'll add 1 square with this x square and 2x term, and subtraction will be done from the constant term always. So 2 minus 1 will be your 1. So it changes to this form. As is, it becomes your x plus 1 whole square plus 1 square. So you can put x plus 1 as t, so that it changes to 1 upon integral t square plus your e square. Okay, t square as plus e square. So this formula will be applied here, log mod x plus root x square plus e square, right? So in place of t, if you are taking t, and then you will take replace it by x plus 1, and this result can be obtained, right? Number 11 is your 1 upon quadratic, and now this quadratic is not having x square coefficient as 1. So firstly, let's make the perfect square by taking it alone. Okay, so you can also continue with the integral and 1 upon form, but let us learn how to make the perfect square of this denominator. So take 9 common first, it becomes x square plus 6x by 9 plus 5 by 9. Now what is half of coefficient of 6 by 9 means 2 by 3. Okay, so what is the half of coefficient of this? This is your 1 by 3 square. Okay, because half of 2 by 3 is 1 by 3 whole square, that is 1 by 9. So I have to add and subtract your 1 by 3 whole square. Okay, so the addition will be done with your x square plus 2x term, and the subtraction will be done with the constant term. So this becomes, if you see, this is a square and this is b square, so it becomes a plus b whole square, and you can see from here it is 4 by 9, which can be written as 2 by 3 whole square, right? Now what can I do is, either I can directly see from here, okay, or I can put x plus 1 upon 3 as t that way also, but don't forget to divide by the d dx of x plus 1 by 3. Okay, so you need to remember. Now here that will be your 1 only, so it is safe for this question. So it changes to 1 upon x square plus e square, which is 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a. So you know this a is your this 2 by 3, so 1 upon a tan inverse and x upon a, right? Take LCM, it is, this will be cancelled, and you will get it as, okay, 3 3 is a 9, this will give you, and 1 upon 6 times tan inverse 3x plus 1 upon 3. In number 12, okay, be careful. In number 12, actually you have to adjust the quadratic. Adjust the quadratic means take negative sign common, so it becomes your minus times x square plus 6x minus 7. Now make the perfect squares, which will be adding and subtracting half of coefficient of x, that is 6, that is your 3. 3 square is 9. So add and subtract 9 inside by taking this negative sign common. Okay, so it is minus times x plus 3 whole square minus 16. Now remember, this complete term has to go inside the root. You remember that, because this is a root term, right? And as I told you, that this negative sign means will be your complex term, because a root never allows negative. Okay, so I have to avoid this negative. I have to avoid making iota term. So I will just means interchange the these position of this a square and x square term, right? So the, because you can see from here that must adjust negative sign outside equation in the bracket, because otherwise we will get root minus 1, which is iota. Okay, so means instead of writing it as your x plus 3 whole square minus 16, better to write it as 4 square minus x plus 3 whole square, and the sign will be adjusted. Now this equation can be represented as perfect square in this form, and by it, as it is of the form 1 upon integral root a square minus x square, so it is sine inverse x upon e plus c. In the next one, again, this is factorized, so I'll just multiply, change it to quadratic. This is again 1 upon root quadratic. Now, as x square is free from any coefficient other than 1, so half of this is minus 3 by 2. Its whole square is to be added and subtracted, right? So it becomes x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 2 whole square, right? So this question changes to this form, right? And this is your integral 1 upon root x square minus a square, which is log mod x plus root x square minus a square, okay? So you can go for that purpose also, means you can put x minus 3 by 2 as t also, as per your convenience. Because here it is not affecting as ddx of x minus 3 by 2 is already 1. But if it would have been 3 by 2 minus x, right, the ddx will be minus 1, and for which you have to divide by that. So it is also suggested that in that case, means the ddx is not 1, you can put it as t and then proceed for the next is again your 8 plus 3x minus x square. Again, the quadratic is to be adjusted with the negative sign. Okay, then make the perfect square by adding this and subtracting as 3 by 2 whole square, so that it becomes your x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 41 by 4. Now again, negative sign is to be adjusted, so it is root, because it is 41 by 4 minus x minus 3 by 2 whole square. So which can be, because you have to express it in the term of a square minus x square or x square minus a square. So this becomes root 41 by 2 whole square, right? So this integral changes to this form. This is of again integral 1 upon root a square minus x square, which integral is sine inverse x upon a. So this is your x. This is a, take LCM, 2 and 2 gets cancelled. And I get it as 2x minus 3 upon root 41 plus c. In 15 also, again, you have to change it to quadratic. Now, this is a general quadratic equation. So, it will be like x square minus x times a plus b plus ab. I would suggest please practice such questions because in these questions, you may commit some mistake. As you can see from here, the half of coefficient is a plus b by 2 whole square. So, you have to add and subtract so that you get this whole square x minus a plus b by 2 whole square. And this term as it is a bigger term, so you need to work it out, right? So it can be reduced by c taking the LCM. It becomes your a plus b whole square will give you a square plus b square plus 2ab. So this complete term will be a square plus b square minus 2ab, which is your a minus b whole square by 4. So means this complete can be written as a minus b by 2 whole square. So my question changes to x minus this and minus a square, okay? So this is x square minus a square format, which is again log mod, and you can put the value of, means in place of x you need to take as x minus a plus b by 2, and in place of a you have to take a minus b by 2, right? So this is in solved pattern, this is the desired answer. Next comes the very important method, that is linear upon quadratic or linear upon root quadratic or linear into root quadratic, right? And in such questions, always remember, write the linear as a times ddx of quadratic without the root, okay, ddx of quadratic plus b, right? Then what we will do, we will compare the coefficients, and this comparison will give me how to break my linear, okay, how to break my linear. So I break my linear in that form and I will get two integrals, right, two integrals. In case of linear upon quadratic, I'll get two integrals as f dash x upon fx plus 1 upon quadratic. In case of linear upon under root quadratic, I'll get it as fx raised to power n into f dash x plus 1 upon root quadratic. Okay. And the third, we will see how it can be splitted. So, C question number 16 is there. As it is clearly visible, it is of the form linear upon root quadratic. So, I'll put my this linear as ddx of my denominator. Okay. So, that can be framing also. But here, as you can see in this question, simply also means this actually, these rules are framed so that you can easily break this linear, okay? But here you can see as the derivative is 4x plus 1. Just listen to me. The derivative of denominator is 4x plus 1, right? So directly also, instead means because the linear is breakable easily, so I can just work out as I will put this denominator as t, right? So that I simply will get it as dt upon root. So this is a simple question which actually don't need this linear upon root quadratic type of execution, because the direct derivative is present there. So integration is t raised to power minus half dt, which is your t half upon half plus c, and which is 2 root t, and the value of t will give you this answer. Right? Now see, in this question again, this such question we have discussed few minutes back, right? So again, the very first thing comes to the mind is break the numerator, right? Split it in two integrals, okay? Now this is the direct formula. This is the direct formula, and this is 1 upon your x square minus e square, right? So which the formula is your log mod x plus root x square minus e square plus c, okay? And 2 is for this thing outside. And this your x upon root x square minus 1, you know, for this the derivative of x square means you need not divide and multiply by 2, okay? If you skip this step also, you can also skip it as. You just put this x square minus 1 equal to t. Now, as like the previous question number 16 we discussed, see, the derivative of this quadratic is there at the top, direct derivative, okay? So, x dx will be dt by 2. So, this question changes to half dt by root t, right? So, again, it is half t minus half. And again, as per the previous question, this can be integrated like this, right? And both these values means this was integrated earlier and this was integrated like this. So, put back the values in this integral I is root x square minus 1 plus 2 log mod this, and altogether, because I use the constant here, so means all the constants obtained after this integration also will be merged in this c to give you a ultimate constant, okay? So even if the constant is written once, that is also okay. Now this is a very good question, number 18. Now you can see the direct derivative is not there. Can you see that the derivative will be your 6x plus 2? So 6x plus 2, you cannot get the direct derivative here. So it's better now, let us see the breakage. And for it, I'll proceed by linear is equal to a times ddx of quadratic plus b. Okay. Now this linear is a times, what is ddx of, this is 2 plus 6x plus b. Okay. Now equate means separate all the terms, 2a plus 6ax plus b. Right. So it will be 6ax plus 2a plus b. Right. Now equate the coefficients, this coefficients of the variable x and the constants with this other one. So 6a from here is your 5. So a I'll get it as 5 by 6. Right? And 2a plus b is a constant, which you get it as minus 2, because the constant term to other side is just minus 2. Now a is 5 by 6 and you can get b by solving it as minus 11 by 3. So what do I get? Means come back here. Now you have to, after you solve this much, please always come back to this step. Okay? Now, what I learned how to break 5x minus 2. It can be written as your a times, means 5 by 6 times 2 plus 6x minus 11 by 3. Okay. Now, change this means 5x minus 2 as this complete term. So, the question will be split it into, means I'll split this term upon the denominator minus 11 by 3 upon. And as I told you, in case of linear upon quadratic, you will get it as f dash x upon fx, see from here, 6x plus 2 derivative is present. And minus 1 upon b times 1 upon quadratic, okay? So this is I1, this is I2, right? So this is, you know that you can put the denominator as t, okay? This is your dt by t form, okay? Or you can directly apply, write the formula alongside and directly integrate, like f dash x upon fx is log mod fx, okay? So this becomes log mod of this, right? So the next is 1 upon quadratic, and for it, again the same thing. You have to make it free, means you may have to make the perfect square, make it free from constant, and this coefficient 3, then take it outside, then add half of this coefficient will be 1 by 3 whole square, right? So it changes to this form, right? And again, see which form is created. It is root 3 by whole square. So I'll get the form as 1 upon x square plus c square, right? So it is, you will get separate depending upon which type of quadratic equation is there. So 1 upon e tan inverse x upon e. So this part can be integrated like this to give the answer. Now put back all the both the values here. So it becomes your 5 by 6, your log of this you obtained, minus 11 by 3 times I2 is your this, 1 by root 2 tan inverse 3x plus 1 upon root 2 plus c, right? Again, number 19 is of this form. Again, you have to open the denominator to get a quadratic equation x square minus 9x plus 20. Again, you can see 2x minus 9, the derivative is not, means directly you're not getting. So I'll again learn the breakage. So it is linear is equal to a times ddx of denominator is 2x minus 9 plus v. So after equating, you will get 2a will be equated to 6a is 3, and your minus 9a plus v equal to 7, the constant term to other side, see from here. Okay, so put the value of a as 3, b is your 34, right? So come back, I told you where to come back, okay? Have to come back here so that I can learn how to break 6x plus 7 to 3 times, okay, 2x minus 9 plus 34. You can even open it. You will open it and you can check it that it changes to 6x plus 7 only. So, right, I'll change my 6x plus 7 by this, whatever I obtained. Then I'll break it this upon this separate integral. Take 3 outside plus 34 outside and 1 upon under root quadratic. Now, I told you it will be your fx of this your function raised to power n into derivative. Okay. So, it is 3i1 plus 34i2. See this i1. Put this x square minus 9x plus 20 as t. 2x minus 9 is your dx is dt. So, it changes to dt by root t. Right. So, t minus half. It is t half upon half 2 root t. So, this is the integral. Second is your 1 upon root quadratic. So, again, change the root quadratic to perfect square, like here x square is free form constant. So half of 9 is 9 by 2. So I'll add and subtract 9 by 2 whole square. So this changes to your x minus 9 by 2 whole square minus half square. So this is of this format. So directly I'll apply this rule and putting back that values of I1 and I2 here back in this my I1, I'll get my answer as this. Okay. So you need to do a lot of practice in such. Again, number 20 is your linear upon your means you can go by x upon means you can break the numerator also, but that will just stretch the length of the question. So see here what you can do is you just put linear as a times d dx of quadratic plus b. So it is your you will get as your means the 2a as coefficient is 1. So a is minus half and 4a plus b is 2. So that is c. Here the constant term is 2. So a minus half will give you b as 4. So you learnt x plus 2 can be written as minus 5 times 4 minus 2x plus 4. So break this. You will get two integrals like take minus 1 by 2 outside. And this is this. Okay. Now this is I1 means I'll just focus on this. Let's not take the constants plus 4i2. So I1 is this. Okay. Can you see here 2x minus 4 is the direct integral. So substitute. Okay, and as I told you, you'll get dt upon root t. So t minus half, again this integral as we did in the earlier questions also. And it is 1 upon your quadratic. Okay, so I'll need to make it as perfect square. Now please don't worry that we are not having that term of means that term which involve the constant. Okay, so that is okay. But here you need to means take the negative sign common to make it as minus x square minus 4x. Okay. Now half of 4 is your 2. So add and subtract 2 square, that is 4 minus 4. Okay. And then now at this step, don't, because the question is involving root, don't forget to flip the places of e square first and then so as to adjust this negative sign. Right. Now the integral is of the form of 1 upon your e square minus x square root, which is sine inverse x upon a, which directly can be taken as this. Right. Now put back the values of I1 and I2. Calculated from here in this, so it is minus half into your sine this your minus half into I1 is your this integral which we took it as 2 times root 4x minus x square. So minus half into 2 means it is just minus root 4x minus x square plus 4 times. Okay, I2 is your just sine inverse x minus 2 upon 2 plus c. Okay, next is again linear upon root quadratic. Put linear as a times t dx of quadratic plus b. Okay, 2a is 1 constant term, 2a plus b is 2, a half, b is 1. Put back how you know how to come back here. Okay, come back here. So this is your x plus 2 is half times 2x plus 2 plus 1. So you have known how to split that into two integrals. So again, this is I1 plus this is I2. Okay, so okay, put this as t. So this dx is dt. So this becomes again you're finding that the forms are almost same. Dt upon root 2, that is t minus half. So t half upon half 2 root t, 2 root 2 is this. Again, this is your 1 upon root quadratic. So change it to perfect square. It becomes x plus 1 whole square plus root 2 square. Use this formula, the appropriate formula by checking the form, and you'll get this as. And put back both the integral values here. Half of I1 is your 2 times root x square plus 3, so half into 2 will cancel. We just get as root x square plus 2x plus 3 plus, and the next is your this value which you obtained for I2, log mod x plus 1 plus root x square plus 2x plus 3 plus again 22 is linear upon quadratic. Okay, so linear is a time d dx of this is 2x minus 2 plus b. So again 2 is 1, c from here, and your minus 2a plus b is 3. Okay, so I'll get a half b 4, x plus 3 can be splitted like this. So c, I can break it in integrals. So I1, I2, c from here, direct integral is there, right? So it is your dt upon t form, log mod t. And again here you have to change it to quadratic. So as 6 is, you can see 6 is not a, you will not be able to express it as a whole square. So you will write it as root 6 whole square, okay? So it will be your root 6 whole square, okay? So apply the formula of your, apply the formula of 1 upon x square minus e square, that is 1 upon 2a log mod x minus a upon x plus a. So it is your x is this, x minus a upon x plus a, okay? Now put back the values of I1 and I2 here and you will get this answer. Number 23 is again linear upon root quadratic, okay? So see, this is linear a times t dx of quadratic plus b. So 2a is 5a, 5 by 2. 4a plus b is 3, b minus 7, c. This is splitted like this. Change the numerator, break it in two integrals, okay? Okay, two integrals. So first one is again, put this denominator as t. This is again c. Things are again repeating. Dt upon root t, t minus half t, half upon half, 2 root t is the integral. Other one is your 1 upon root quadratic. Change it to perfect square and apply the appropriate formula and you can integrate this question. Wait, this is your 1 upon quadratic. Choose the correct answers. 1 upon quadratic, so see how will you make change it to perfect square. So this changes to x plus 1 whole square plus 1, okay? So it is of this form. So 1 upon e tan inverse x upon e plus c. So means option number B is correct. For this one, again, you can see that I have to adjust the negative sign. See? The negative sign, okay, because it becomes minus times x square minus 9 by 4x, right? So half of coefficient of x term, you will add 9 by 8 whole square and subtract also, right? So you know it becomes like this, but because we are dealing with under root terms, so I'll flip the positions of 9 by 8 whole square and this. So the appropriate formula will be, your this changes to 1 upon root e square minus x square, which is sine inverse x upon e, right? And you will get option number B is the correct answer. Okay, so this concept must be. So this is all regarding your exercise 7.4. I hope whatever is done is clear to you. Please practice it a lot because it is a very important concept and you are going to get definitely a question of based upon this form in integration, either in case of say 1 mark or 2 mark question or 4 mark question or even the 6 marks question. Okay, so practice this area. Thank you so much.